just walk in my shoes and you
It is a known fact that homelessness is becoming a major problem that increases every year. A huge number of people who are affected by this plague are now exceeding to an alarming record in the U.S. alone, and children contribute to one-fifth of this increase. As this number increases day by day, people struggle to get basic services through shelters. Recently, I ventured to the streets to pass out shoes. However, in doing so, I realized that I was not equipped for the crowd of people who searched my bags for various sizes. To the homeless, it did not matter the color or brand. In one incident, a man was happy to walk away with a pair of cleats.
Hello, my name is Jack Lewis. I'm currently collecting items such as socks, clothes, and toiletries for the homeless. And I'm calling to see if I could display a box at your business so that customers may drop off donations.
Can I help you?
Would you mind if I set up this shoebox for your customers and employees to just drop off shoes and toiletries, clothing, and stuff like that?
Sure, you can set it right here.
Alright.
We'll collect them for you.
Alright, thanks.
Thank you.
Alright.
Helping people getting shoes. See, look, this is leather and rubber and...
Still collecting shoes, clothing, toiletries, bags. You could just drop it off right up there, and I'll collect it at the end of the day, and thank you for anybody who's made a donation.
I'm calling to see if I can make a donation to your shelter. We're right at the Must Homeless Shelter, which we're taking three different vehicles, and they're going to take all the shoes, clothes, and toiletries that we have, and they're going to distribute it to other homeless shelters. I have learned that there are many homeless people in my own community who wear worn and tattered shoes, and in some situations, had no shoes at all. It was a great experience for me to go through this Must warehouse to see all the clothes, toiletries, furniture, food that they've collected over even a short period of time, and they were getting ready to like put these in trucks and send them off when I got there.
Thank you for doing this.
You're welcome.
We can't do what we do without volunteers. People like you that do the food drives, the clothing drives, the shoe drives. But this is the donation center here. We just take in all the donations and we sort them and organize them in our different locations, basically place orders with
them. How often do you bring the stuff to the homeless people?
Day services, we only hand out Monday through Friday, but our overnight shelter in the soup kitchen, they operate 24 hours a day, 365 days a year.
Do you bring it to them or do they come to you?
They come to the to our locations and get it.
Can I bring you lunch?
Hello.
What's your name?
My name is Jack Lewis.
Where did your passion for the homeless start?
Well, it started about a couple of years ago. I was working at the Atlanta Community Food Bank, and I was packaging it. I wanted to know what was happening, where it went. So I started working with more things. I worked with Project Open Hand.
What are you currently doing for the homeless?
I'm collecting old shoes and clothing that I'm going to take and deliver to the homeless.
So how are you getting the word out with this shoe drive?
Well, I've set up posters all across my school talking about the shoe drive. This is my shoe box right here. It's pretty easy to see. I have posters all around, and people would normally take bags of shoes, clothing, and put it here, or they'll just drop off a bag around it. And I'll collect it at least once a week, at least once or twice a week.
So you enjoy working with the homeless?
Yeah, I always have and I always will.
What do you enjoy the most about it?
What I enjoy the most is really seeing the expression that they have when they receive things that I usually take for granted and that they probably thought was easy for everybody else to get, but they can't.
So what type of things do you think we take for granted that the homeless people don't?
Clothing, shoes, food mostly.
And
It's a blessing. It's a blessing to meet y'all. Y'all are doing something blessed, man, for a lot of people out here.
We need jobs, man. We need to take care of our family.
We've got men's shoes tomorrow. We've got bags. We've got clothes. We've got toiletries.
Yeah.
And
socks.
Socks and
Well, I'm working with an organization and delivering food to homeless people. We just finished delivering a bunch of bags of food everywhere.
What did you notice about where the homeless people stayed? Like, what did you notice about
that? They didn't have much.
What kind of place did we leave as far as where they sleep? What type of place was it?
It was under a bridge.
Okay.
How did you feel about that whole experience?
It just made me, just kind of made me shocked, upset, knowing that these people are living like this.
Like 8 times. Good family, good mother, father, grandmother. Had a hard time.
Have you been homeless?
Since last August, last year. To now.
What do the homeless people fight over?
Everything. Shoes, clothes, food, money. Steal all the homeless folks' stuff. Then, you know, the drug I'm drinking, smoke or whatever, you know. I don't knock that, but, you know, it's a turning point for everything. Life goes on. You know, but everybody has ups and downs. You can be rich today and pull them out. Thank you very much.
How important is it to have comfortable shoes when you're homeless?
Very, because you're constantly walking every day, all day and all night. I have blisters on my feet right now from walking in those shoes last night. So it's very important to have comfortable shoes.
Right.
And socks. If you don't, you will pay for it. Trust me. I know.
As I watch the few homeless people walk away with a new pair of shoes, it gives me comfort in knowing that I'm able to offer a glimpse of hope.